actually Hrithik Ranjan Shetty.
Yeah,
make that as a presenter. Yeah.
Slides, please.
Yeah. You're able to see me also?
Yes.
Okay.
So that's great. So we will start the session now.
Okay. And
very good evening to all of you. Thanks for joining in today's program. As you all know, this is the third part of hemodynamics series, which has been initiated by Dr. Professor Ranjan Shetty. And I'm really happy and, you know, to share with all of you that the last two episodes that we have done, we have got a phenomenal, you know, feedback from all the participants. And that has really encouraged us to do such kind of episodes. So I would not take much of time without delaying. I would again request Dr. Ranjan Shetty to take up the sessions. Some quick notes or the request from all of you. Do not turn your videos on because that will unnecessarily will consume your data and you might not hear or, you know, see slides in a nicer way. And another thing is, if you have any question, you can put it in the comment box or you can ask it by raising your hand so that doctor can stop and then he can ask you what is the question you have. So that the flow and the, you know, discussion should not be disturbed, right? So these are some of the things, and definitely if you have anything in coming in between, raise your hand and let us know. Right. So thank you, Dr. Ranjan. Please start the session.
Okay. So you're able to see Rohit, see and...
Yes.
Okay. So, yeah. So it's clear, no? That you're able to see the slide and when I'm projecting as well as when I'm... not projecting, no? Yeah.
Thing is clear and visible.
Nice. Visible. Okay. So I'm just going to, I'll start now. And sorry about the little bit technical issue which we had in the beginning. This time we thought we'll change the format and, you know, so that you can unmute yourself and ask questions. And I realized that most of your exam is actually started now. Some of you exam is already started, and I think most DM centers are already writing their exam now. So Rohit, this is clear now? The line is clear? This is clear? Yeah.
Yeah, clear, sir.
Okay. Good. So today's is it's the third session of our the discussion what we are having, and today we are going to discuss on angiogram, how to identify angiogram, what are the views, and how do we manage. And like usual, there will be little theory. I'm going to cut down the theory, and we are going to have some question answer where you can answer. So just to make it more interactive, we are doing it in Teams. But even in this, I think there are, I'm sure there are some technical issues which we will face because right now I can only see my screen. I actually can't see the chat box or this, but I think Rohit will keep looking at the chat box, and if there is anything he can tell, we can ask people to unmute also. Now, this is an important part, and now that with your exam system, which is a little different from before, you could have a lot of these, and probably for DNB exam, they may be projecting from the center, so you could have a angio which is being played. And almost all exam, you know, some sort of angiogram is already brought, and you're expected to understand some simple thing. Now, how do you describe an angiogram? First important is to tell what is the angiogram of. You know, technically you'll start with telling this is the angiogram, this is a ventriculogram or injection into chamber. You start with, you know, this is the view, which is important, we'll come to that. What is the catheter which is used, the course and the position, where it starts and where it ends, that's very important. Chamber, which is opacified, which is also very important. Contrast needs to be followed. This is something which is extremely important. You need to see that it comes into the particular place, and the levo phase of it, you know, where exactly it terminates. Now, how do we identify views? I'm sure all of you do know how to do it, and it may be very simple. So this this actually tells you there are two things to know, whether it is AP, RAO, lateral, or you know, that is the first aspect. And the second aspect is to tell whether it is cranial or whether it is a plain view. Most of us, you know, all of you know to describe coronary angiogram, so you are pretty good at these things. But remember, AP comes like this, where the, you need to look at the sternum and the vertebra. So if you are able to look at the vertebra straight, you know, just dead on, that is the AP view. Now, don't think that the spine has to be in the center or middle or later. It's possible that spine is in the center, but even in this center, it's possible that you could move it right and left. It's not about whether the spine is right or left or center. It's also the orientation of the spine. So you look at this example A, you realize the spine looks straight at you. It could be on right side, it could be left side, it could be center, but it's going to look at you. That's the AP view. Now, if you have a rotation of the spine, if it's rotated, so that if you have to reconstruct it, it's rotated this way and you have the ribs coming out, that will become RAO. The same rotation on the opposite, if you see it on your right, screens left, you always describe the angio based on your finding. So if you see it on your right rotated this way, then it would actually be called as LAO view. Now, how do you distinguish whether it is a cranial view or whether it is a plain view? Like, for example, how do you distinguish LAO cranial from a plain LAO or AP cranial from the plain AP? So if anybody can unmute and answer, I'll be very happy. So how do you distinguish a plane? For example, the question is, how do you distinguish LAO plane from LAO cranial view? Anybody would want to unmute and answer? Rohit, are they able to unmute?
They can do it.
They can do, no? I don't know who are the participants because I'm not able to see the list with this. So if there is anybody who can...
You can see the diaphragm that's coming in the way of the thing. If that is seen occupying more than 50% of the heart, then you can say that it is...
Excellent. Who is this? You may have to tell your name. Our system is, you know, still not perfect. Yeah, you could introduce yourself. So the answer is, all of you know X-ray, no? Like you know chest X-ray. In chest X-ray, you have diaphragm and you have heart. And heart sits on diaphragm. So if you have heart sitting on diaphragm, they are plain views, okay? Whether it is AP, whether it is LAO, whether it is RAO. Heart sitting on diaphragm, sitting on. If you see heart submerged in diaphragm, means you are able to see diaphragm, but heart is within it, like 50% or whatever percentage. You see heart and you also see diaphragm, whereas heart is within it, then it becomes a cranial view. Okay, otherwise they look the similar. If you are only looking at the spine and the orientation, both cranial, plane and cranial view, that, for example, LAO plane and LAO cranial. See, when you do right coronary artery angio, you realize initially you are hooking in plane. Daniel or Areo? What is the second one?
Hello.
It's written, so it's more about your visual test. It's not really about your IQ test. But remember, the screen appears as if it is towards the right, no? It looks like your left and screen's right, but this is not a RFO image, the third one. It's AP, okay? Because it's AP because the way the spine looks also is important. It's not about where is it in the frame. It is the way it looks. Here the spine is dead on. It's looking at you, so it is AP. To say cranial, you have to see that the heart actually is engulfed on diaphragm. If it is not, if it is a plain AP view, it's like X-ray. Heart separate, diaphragm separate. Here it is engulfed, okay? Now, let's see the ventricular injection. I'm going to go a little slow here, and you all please ask your question. There's no way we can see all the examples, but it's probably more important for us to understand. No. See, in ventricle, you have to identify. If there is an injection of ventricle, I just have some 4 or 5 slides where I'm going to touch, you know, dead so that we understand we are all in the same this one. So ventricular injection, it's important to identify RV and LV. Now, how do you identify this? Can anybody answer that? How do you say the chamber which you are injecting is RV or LV? Please unmute.
Sir, right wind.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Sir, this is Dr. Abhijit, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Sir, so right ventricular is trabeculated.
Very good.
Contour is trabeculated.
Dr. Abhijit, extremely correct. But remember, it is the, you see, the free wall of both ventricles are trabeculated. Okay. So if you just look at the free wall, you may go wrong. It is the septal side which you need to see. Okay. The septal side of RV is fully trabeculated. The septal side of LV is clean. Okay, it's smooth. But if you look at free wall, even LV will appear slightly trabeculated. So
yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
Sir, the valve always goes with ventricle.
Correct. But that's difficult in angio to pick up. It's possible, difficult. That's very useful in echo, okay? But it's difficult in angio. Does anything else go with the ventricle?
So, the false tendon will be in a left ventricular. That again in echo.
Yeah, it's very good in echo. But angio, there is one more thing which you are very likely to see, and it always goes with ventricle. Okay? So, the answer there, Dr. Abhijit, is coronary. Corrected TGA, RV will be the systemic ventricle. But if you see the aorta getting filled, you will see that the RCA will actually be supplying that RV and left coronary. You will have left main dividing into LAD and L6. The coronaries follow the ventricle. Okay, please remember that. So what are the points here? Smooth and shadow, you already saw. Coronaries following ventricle. Other things are more in echo. The third and very important point is the anterior ventricle. That means the ventricle below the sternum is invariably RV. Okay, any physiology, except in case of crisscross heart, all other condition, the anterior chamber below the sternum is always RV. So I hope all of you followed this.
Yes, sir.
So when you have a ventricular injection, describe it. We'll come to some of the example. Describe the injection, see how it is, look at the trabeculation, especially in the septum, and make sure that if you see the coronaries, you're not actually injecting for coronary, but greater, if aorta comes, invariably you see coronary, they follow the ventricle and substernal chamber. Almost in all physiologies, RV. RV is always anterior. This is what you realize, even in single ventricle physiology, when you have a rudimentary RV, it's almost always anterior, okay? A rudimentary LV is almost always posterior. Always gives rise to one great artery. Okay, very rarely you get DOLV, no? DORV almost always gives one great artery. RV may or may not have inflow. Whereas LV, this is combination. This is for echo. This is for you to understand. LV, most of the time has inflow. LV may or may not have outflow. Okay, so the two ventricles, they are not just mirror image. They have different rules to be followed. And they work differently. So when you have a ventricular injection, ventricles are tripartite. Remember that. They have three parts. In cases of single ventricle, one or two of these parts disappear. Okay. Most of the time, the inlet, RV has inlet, the chamber, and the outlet. Last part to disappear in a ventricle in dysmorphosis is actually the outflow. Outflow part of most ventricles are maintained. So I hope that is clear. That's how you identify ventricle. RV, any RV angio, look for RV angio. Okay, you can identify, as we discussed, it's clear, it's done in cases of TOF, it's done in cases for pulmonary stenosis. Look at RVOT. Look for a dynamic or a, this construction. How do you do RV injection? RV injection needs, obviously, all injections, you need a multi-hole catheter. Typically, just a single end hole you never use. What is the reason that we don't use a single end hole for a injection? And anyone answer?
I want to know, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
The end hole can get trapped within the trabeculae.
Very good. Yes, then?
And it can induce the VPCs.
Correct. That's one. Anything else? There's one more
can
reason.
Cause which perforation. Is can cause perforation.
Very good. Because, see, imagine you use a power injector on an end hole. So you are hitting with units like a dissecting needle now. The force could be so strong that it can actually perforate the chamber. You know, it's like although it's like a water, but if you hit a water in too much force, it can even, you know, a rock can be cut, no? So the same problem occurs, the dissection and perforation occurs. So you do not use an end hole catheter. But most important is you use side hole catheter. Multiple side holes is always better, you know. And the typical catheter for the left side is pigtail. For right side, you have different catheters like NIH. But even pigtail is used. If someone asks you which pigtail is used for right-sided angio, the answer is actually angulated pigtail. You know, pigtail comes as straight, pigtail says, bend it can easily enter RV and the angio can be taken. So these are all the catheter which produce the pigtail. Don't worry, I'll be sharing the slides, so you have the list of catheter which we serve. What is the site of RV injection? Typically RV injection has deep in, as close as apex, but we do not want it to be very deep. The views used, you use AP view and you use lateral view. AP view is best if you want to look at the PAs. Typically, you give on 10 to 20 degree cranial angulation when we do lateral. Because as I kept discussing, RV is almost always an anterior chamber. Lateral view is good view. Okay. Injection 25 to 30 ml is, you know, it could be 60 ml, which was olden times. Now we don't give that. 30 to 40 ml is fine. And rate of injection has to be higher. It's 15 to 25 ml per second. PSI depends on the catheter. You know, PSI is that is one more number. When you do coronary, the PSI is 300. If you are using NIH and such, the PSI would be around 600. Pigtail more than 6 French can actually take 900 to 1200 PSI. Now, this is how RV injection looks in, this is how the injection look in different view. So, this is how the RV angiogram is seen. So, can anybody describe this angiogram? If you are supposed to describe it, how will you describe it?
So this is a catheter angio.
Yes.
A catheter is from IVC to RA to RV.
Yes.
Catheter is.
View. What would be the view?
View is PA view, sir.
Yes, PA or AP view.
AP view.
Is there a slight cranial?
Yes, sir. We can see the diaphragm.
See, if it was an X-ray, you know, heart and the diaphragm would have been completely separated. So here, there it's a shallow cranial view. Okay. Then when do you decide to take a shallow RAO? When do you decide to take a shallow LAO?
For the septum, shallow RAO, sir.
Septum means RV septum, the interventricular septum, is it?
Yes.
Yeah, interventricular septum, will come to that. They are typically in abnormal case. In normal cases, it's typically the best in LAO cranial view. It's called long axis. We'll come to that. There's one condition where AP view is needed for septum. Which is that condition? If you want to look at ventricular
TGA.
Yeah, corrected TGA. Corrected TGA is one condition, not TGA. TGA ventricles are normal. Corrected TGA is where AP view gives the septum best. So if you have to put a pacemaker for a corrected TGA, you could do it in AP. You don't have to turn RAO, LAO. Angio also, if there are some examples, we'll see. So the AP view will be the best view to you see. But otherwise, it's not AP or PA, whatever you want to call, is not good. So you decide slight RAO or slight LAO. You know, ipsilateral RAO, LAO, the PAs are seen better, especially origin of PA. So if I have a doubt of right PA stenosis, I'll go slight RAO, epicranial with slight RAO. If I have doubt of left PA stenosis, I will go slight LAO. Okay, so PAs are, so almost always RV angio in an AP view is done with AP shallow cranial with tilt to RAO, LAO depending on which condition. So I think whoever described it well, you need to describe as this is the AP with slight cranial view, venous catheter coming from IVC RA to the chamber, injection into chamber shows that it's highly trabeculated. Look at the septum, you can see the septum, and look at the septal side. The septal side is highly trabeculated. It also shows the function is good. The negative shadow, what you see here, the tongue-like negative shadow is the tricuspid valve. Are you all able to see that negative shadow there? Moving negative shadow, tongue-like negative shadow across the catheter is the tricuspid valve in this case. This is how mitral and tricuspid valve are seen. Injection shows good injection with good PA size, and right and left PA appears good. And we are not able to see the Leo phase, so we are not going to describe the Leo phase. So is it clear? One of you may have to speak up. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So I'll go to the next one. Anyway, there are a lot of examples. Now, LV angiogram. How do we do LV angiogram? So all of you are aware. Just remember there are, it's typically a pigtail now. There's no other catheter now for LV angio. It is pigtail. But remember, there were other catheters, and remember the names of this. There is a, for LV ventriculogram, this angiobarman is anyway present even now, that, but typically for LV we don't use, most of the time LV we use a pigtail catheter. One more very important thing to distinguish a right side, that is the venous side and artery side. If you see a catheter going up and coming down, it's very likely it's going through arterial side. If you see the catheter directly entering heart and going up, going down, it is typically a venous side. So if you see last example, you have IVC, RA, RV. You don't see it go circle. Whereas this example, if you see, there's a catheter which goes up and comes down and comes here. So this is a arterial. So it's a retrograde cannulation. pigtail catheter. And what is the view? Can somebody say the view in this angio? I mean, it's not a running image, but what is the view in this case?
Leocranial.
RAO view.
RAO. No, it's RAO. Look at the, see, even if you don't see the sternum, look at the way the ribs are pointing. You know, if you have to, if you extend the rib backward, you'll realize that it, the spine is here and spine is rotated. So this is RAO and it is a cranial view. Why cranial? Because diaphragm and heart are, you know, they are engulfing each other. Okay, the catheter should be produced prepared mid to distal. If you keep it very outward, you will miss the ventricular function and you will miss the apical VSD. If you keep too apical, you're going to have lots of ectopic. So it should be, you know, between mid to distal. That's where the catheter is. Volume depends on the chamber and the hemodynamic, but typically you need 30 to 50 or 30 to 35 ml at the speed of 10 to 15 ml per second and PSI of around 1200 if you're actually using a higher French catheter. Remember, this is, I think this is, there's a type error here. If it's 4 French, it should be 400 to 600. If it is 6 French, it should be 800 to 1200. But if you're looking at coronary, it should be lesser. So what are the views for LV? The views for LV is RAO 30 and LAO 60, you know, slight LAO cranial. RAO 30 is the plain RAO. One very important thing what you should understand is RAO 30. There are at least 8 to 10 angios which are done in RAO 30. Can someone tell what are those angios which are done in RAO 30? Because this is the question which you, in an exam, I always tell you, it's a rapid fire. They're going to ask you some questions very rapidly. Be very, you know, be quick to answer them. So what are the angios which are done in RAO 30?
Ventricular septal defect, sir, and for the mitral wall collapse.
Which ventricular? Yes, that's the right answer. But only one ventricular septum defect is found in RAO 30.
Sir, it is usually apical because apex is very, very big.
Yeah, RV, it's, you should call it outlet VSD, okay? Outlet, we'll come to that. We have, I have a, one or two slides on VSD. Outlet VSD, okay, then?
So mitral wall collapse.
MVP, yes. What is the characteristic of MVP? I am happy that somebody answered. What do you see in angio in MVP?
What you call the... bowing of the mitral wall into the LA, that is,
yeah, it's right, it's bowing, but here it looks like a beak. Okay,
beak.
So mitral valve prolapsing backward will appear like a beak because ventricle is now injected. Okay, so the prolapsing will appear like a beaking appearance. Okay, very good. Next, so LV angio 30, mitral valve 30. No, mitral valve, most of the MR is which view? RAO 30. No, RV angio, RAO 30. Outlet VSD, again RAO 30. AR quantification is RAO 30. Okay, RCA, RAO 30. No, RCA, mid to distal RCA, if you want to see, again you have to go to RAO 30. And PDA. No, PDA also. PDA has two views. One is lateral and second is RAO 30. So make a list of things which can be seen in RAO 30. So RV angio, LV angio, to look at mitral valve, to look at tricuspid valve, to assess LV function, to look at MR, look at quantify MR, quantify AR, look at right coronary artery, PDA, and MVP, as somebody rightly pointed out. So did we reach 10? I think we did. Remember this, that you have to tell all this, and wall motion assessment. Okay, LAO 30, again to look at different wall motion. The best part of LAO 30, it's also called LAO 30 cranial, also 20 to 30 cranial is put. This is the view which gives you about iotomitral continuity. Okay, LAO is the view which gives you iotomitral continuity. RAO is the view which gives the function. So let's see how to do RV analysis. This is RAO diastolic, RAO systolic. So if you're looking, if you want to identify the EF, earlier EF was only angio based, no? So angio based VF is actually calculated here. The mitral valve comes here, the aorta sinuses are here. This is how it looks. And this view almost is typically a plain RAO view. LAVO, again, you can look at region of wall. Please read about what are the corresponding echo views for angio view. Once you do that, things will be easier because now it's more echo corresponding this. Now, can anybody describe this angio which is there in your screen? This is not
LAVO cranial, sir.
Yeah.
LAVO cranial, the catheter is passing.
Very good. It's LAVO cranial. I'm sure nobody has doubt about that. Yes.
The catheter, pictal catheter is passing from the aorta retrogradely into the LV. And yes. Injection is into the LV.
I time in exam by telling pictal catheter, femoral artery, descending aorta, ascending aorta into the chamber. Don't into commit it as LV into the chamber.
Into the chamber. And there is a filling of the ventricle, a simultaneous filling of the other ventricle and the coronaries.
Very good. And okay, so you have picked up most of the points and I'm very happy. So you filling of the ventricle, but is this a smooth ventricle or is it a trabeculated ventricle?
Smooth.
Yeah. See, now when you say smooth or trabeculated, I want you to stop. I'll go back. I want you to stop and think about it. Okay. If you see this area, the lateral area actually looks trabeculated even in LV. You are supposed to look at the septal part. Okay. You're supposed to look at the septal part. Septal path is smooth. So it's a LAVO cranial view. Injection here shows a good ventricular function, but you do see a dye which is coming on this side, which I'm going to describe. And also look at coronary. You are able to see RCA. Since RCA is filling the other chamber, supplying the other chamber, this is likely to be RV and the chamber you are injecting is likely to be LV. Are you able to see mitral valve? Is anybody else is able to see a mitral valve in this case? See this here, are you able to see my this finger which I'm showing in your screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So just look at this area then. If you look at this area, see there is a, this will be the mitral valve, this area. See the negative shadow there, this is mitral valve. In continuation of aorta, this is how the mitral valve looks here. The negative tongue-shaped structure is actually AML and AML is in continuation. So if there is MR, you will see the dye coming to LA here, okay, if there is MR. So this is a case of VSD. I just want you all to see this. I'm going to describe VSD later, but I'm just going want you all to understand this. Now, how do you quantify MR? MR, AR, both are quantified. See, they are seen in all the views, but they are quantified in RAVO 30 view, okay? So grade 1 is just a puff which gets cleared immediately. Grade 2 is a significant puff, but not as dense as LV. 3 is equal to LV and 4 is more than LV. And that's what you see in all the views. So this is how, and but remember it is RAVO view and this is how it looks. I hope this plays. Yeah, no, it doesn't. Oh no, it does. So there is an injection here. And what do you see here? Can somebody describe this? Yes, can anybody? So I won't be able to call your name because I really don't know who is there. Yeah.
So Anup is there? RAVO.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, tell me.
RAVO cranial view, sir.
Yeah, it's RAVO plane view, no? Hardly you understood, no? Ventricle, it's almost RAVO, if at all, the slight cranial, plane RAVO view. Yes, yeah.
Arterial catheter, it is a pictal catheter from descending aorta, ascending aorta,
yes,
and in a chamber. The injection shows filling of left atrium also.
Yes. So first describe the chamber. Chamber looks good. The function looks good. No, chamber. The function looks good. And what do you see? Tongue shaped structure here.
Is mitral valve. So.
Yes, the negative shadow is mitral valve, and you see something ejecting into
left
LA. No, and now the next thing is the dye in LA as much as LV? Is it? It's a significant MR. There is no doubt. No, it's not one puff and coming back. If the dye equivalent to LV, more than LV, or less than LV, that's what you need to tell. What do you think is your guess?
Grade 2 mitral valve.
It's slightly less, but you know, LA seems to be dilated, so I won't be surprised even if it is grade 3, but I'm okay with your grade 2, okay? LA seems to be dilated, no? It looks huge compared to this. So it seems to be dilated. Yeah, it could be grade 2 or maybe grade 3, but definitely not grade 4 MR. Okay, that's how you describe. So view is correct, pigtail is correct, track is correct, the chamber is correct, the ejection, and if there is a Leo phase, you need to go to Leo phase. So same thing with AR, but AR, which view will you use to define AR severity? It's the same thing.
RAO.
Yeah, again it is RAO 30. You can do it in LAO, you can do it to RAO, but severity is assessed in RAO and not LAO. But why did we do a LAO view then? This is a LAO angio, no? LAO cranial angio typically. So why did we do LAO? When do you do LAO for AR?
To look for the ascending
for aorta. Ascending
yes. Aorta. To look at aorta and also to look at the sinuses. Okay. Here in LAO, that's why we use LAO to hook left coronary, right coronary, no? So you see the sinuses very well. So the catheter is in which sinus now in this example? The catheter is actually in the right sinus.
Right coronary.
So this is probably a bicuspid case because I'm not able to see the third sinus very well, but we are going to see the AR. So this is probably that patient has only right and left sinus here and AR. It's a significant AR, but you cannot grade it in this view. But coronaries are seen well, ascending aorta is seen well. Okay. So this is the view which shows different chambers and different views. So aortic root angio, when do we do aortic root angio? When we want to look at the coronaries, we do aortic root angio. Any descending, ascending we have to do. That's typically done in a LAO view, especially like when you have graft. You can also make sure you look at aorta, look at branch of aorta and look at descending aorta. Okay. So in this example, catheter again is in, it's a LAO view. Is it LAO cranial or plain LAO?
Plain LAO.
Very good. So you can easily identify LAO cranial front brain. And where is the catheter? Which sinus is the catheter in?
Right sinus.
So right is where RC arises, but right is not the lowermost sinus. Okay. Right is the anteriormost sinus. RV is anterior, RCA is anterior. Remember that it's the anteriormost sinus, but it is not a lowermost sinus. Which is the lowermost sinus?
Non-coronary
is the lowermost sinus, and left is the posterior sinus. You also need to take a descending aortogram to look at again arch. It's typically taken in AP view, and you may have to look at this. So can somebody describe what is that you're seeing in this view? View and everything, describe it fully. Yeah,
this is a pigtail catheter.
Yes,
in a AP view.
Yes.
The catheter course is from descending aorta to the arch.
Yes.
And the pictal injection shows the cranial neck vessels.
Yes.
Mainly right brachiocephalic trunk and left common carotid and vertebral artery, subclavian artery can be seen, sir.
Yes. Correct. So the aortic branching looks normal. Yes. But what else do you see? Correct. This much is correct.
Reversal of flow.
No, the flow is normal. Is anybody able to see? Look at the lung. Lung looks little funny, no? This area looks little less vascular. This area looks little typically like a funny. So there is a MAPKA here. See, there is a small artery coming, not the one which is very prominent. There is one less prominent here, which is taking blood to the right side. That's why right side looks very funny, you know, with dye. Okay. So this must be a case of TOF physiology where there are MAPKAs or whatever, some aortopulmonary collaterals. Okay. Any doubts? Can you see this aortopulmonary collateral, the small one going here? Not yes. This tiny one, yes. There's one more here. Okay. Okay, now pulmonary PA view, what do we see? You could enter PA, balloon tipped catheter. This will not be a, if you're doing an angio, it's very less likely to be a Schwann. Okay, it's likely to be an angiobermann. And here the selective angiogram of the right PA, looking at the right PA, and then angiogram of the left PA, looking at the left PA. Okay, so that's what is done here. So you can look at the PA. So slight AP cranial is the best view for PA. You can see it in RV angio also. And as I told you, ipsilateral will tell you which is the direction to go. Okay, now this is very important. Sometime you have post Glenn cases. All of you know what Glenn is. And then you should identify the catheter course and that will help. So look at this. What do you see here? What view and what case and what's happening? Can somebody describe it? Sorry, are you able to hear? Yeah.
Pulmonary artery angiogram through the subclavian vein, sir.
Yes, through subclavian SVC vein, no? So this is a Glenn. If you see a catheter coming from the upper part of the body, directly entering PA, it's Glenn. So the injection is in, where is the injection in? Right SVC, no? You need to describe the injection is in right SVC, showing the SVC is patent and it is connecting the PAs. What else will you describe about PAs?
PAs, the central pulmonary, the bifurcation, the stenosis is there, sir.
Yeah, this, see, bifurcation, there could be stenosis, but we are not sure because there is a washout which is happening here. No, there's also some white fluid which is coming from top. There could be a bilateral, bidirectional GANS. So we are not sure. But what you are sure is PAs are confluent. You know, what is confluent? Okay. When PAs are connected to each other, it's called confluent. RPA diameter looks good. As you rightly said, LPA, there are some doubts. Yeah. Left upper part, always look at the x-ray also. You look at this left upper part, this looks very hypovolemic. No, can you see that? The left upper part, see, look at the right upper, it looks full of blood vessel even without injection. But left upper, this area, the blood, there is some focal oligemia. So there could be stenosis in the PA in that area, but you may need a better injection. You may have to do. Why do we do a post Glenn injection? What is the purpose of doing a post Glenn injection?
Just to see whether the Glenn is working.
Yes, and also to look at the pressure, because the Glenn is the first step. Which is the, what is the next step?
If there's any collaterals.
Yes, sometimes the Glenn failure is because of collateral. Next step is Fontan, and before doing Fontan, you want to see that things are fine. One more question which is asked for you is single ventricle physiology and Chaustic criteria. Okay, you are supposed to know all the criteria. What are the things which are not important when you are doing Fontan? You know what are important, 10 criteria, no? Tell me what is not important. Anybody?
Sinus rhythm.
Rhythm is important, no? Yeah, sinus rhythm is important. What is not important? What doesn't matter if you're doing anyway doing a Glenn and Fontan?
Pulmonary venous return, sir.
Very important. It has to be to the heart, no?
Intracardiac kenotone.
Intracardiac, yes, age is not important. Folder. Very good. Whether it is a single ventricle, one and a half ventricle, half up, half down, doesn't matter. Yes. What else is not important?
Age.
Age is, I mean, if you look at the criteria, 5 to 15 is age, no?
Yes, more than 4 years.
Yeah, no, but you know, these are variable, but it's still an important point. But whether there is a VSD, whether it is a single ventricle, whether it's a tricuspid atresia, doesn't matter, no? So that's not it. One more, one thing which is not important is coronary anatomy. It doesn't matter. As long as there is a coronary, yeah, when you're doing a Fontan or for a Fontan single ventricle, the coronary anatomy does not matter. Okay? Okay. So let's look at, I think somebody's audio is on and it is echoing. Can you just mute yourself? Yeah. Now let's see VSD. I'm going to ask you to, so tell me what are the different views which are needed for VSD and how do you know that the view which you have taken is right for that VSD? You understood? For example, you do a LV angio. If there is VSD, dye will fill RV. How do you know you have taken the right view for right VSD? So can anybody answer that?
The septum should be almost all parallel to that particular view, sir. Then only we can be telling.
Yeah, but how do you know it is parallel? What I'm asking you is, you know, you take some angio, you will realize the dye is in the other chamber. You already saw one VSD example. Was it the right view for that VSD is the question. How do you know? Or before that, let me ask, what are the different views for different VSD?
Hepatoclavicular.
Yes, hepatoclavicular or inlet 45-45. It is done for which VSD?
Inlet muscular VSD.
Inlet VSD. Yeah, okay. Inlet VSD, it's hepatoclavicular. That view is also called as what view? What is the other name given to that view?
Four-chamber view.
Yeah, four-chamber of view of the heart. Again, you should know which are the angios which are done in that view. Okay, that's a typical exam question. Remember what view. Okay, what are the other? It's all written, so you just have to read it. So for perimembranous, we call long axis view. That is LAVO 50 to 70, cranial 20 to 30. Long axis view. Outlet is RAVO 30. We already discussed. Muscular, it's variable depending on where it is. And sometime, remember this is usually not written. But sometime you may have to do lateral view for muscular. What is very important is to find out, delineate the margin. Because any injection, dye will come to other side. What we need to see is whether the margin of VSD is delineated. If margin of VSD is delineated, then you have taken the right view. Direction of the jet also is very important. Now look at this example. If you see here, can you see this example on top here? First on top?
Yes, can you all see?
Yeah.
Yes.
So if you see here, you can see the ventricular septum. This is the LAVO cranial view. But you see the ventricular septum, which is very clearly seen. But you also see the gap. No? If you can see the gap, that means you are very sure this was the right view for this VSD. Okay? Because if you have taken a wrong view, imagine you take a RAVO or you take a hepatoclavicular for this, you realize that this will appear as if it is continuous. Okay, so if you are able to see the proper gap with the proper margin, that means that is the right view. So this is best seen. Look at this example. What do you see here? You see a LAVO cranial angiogram with the pigtail catheter into a ventricle. This is the sick negative shadow is of the ventricle. But look at this below the aorta. Obviously, all VSDs are below aorta. So you don't call them sub-aortic VSD. That's the wrong nomenclature. You can't have supra-aortic VSD anyway. No, they'll all be sub-aortic. But below this, you see a VSD with a clear margin. So this is likely to be a perimembranous VSD. How do you know it is perimembranous? It's very well identified in this view. And very important, the dye which comes is actually coming into chamber. So based on this, based on the direction of the dye, also you can identify different VSD. So if it is perimembranous, the dye will go to chamber. If it is inlet, dye will hit opposite RV valve. And if it is outlet, dye will predominantly go to PA. Okay, it will fill PA before it fills the chamber. So outlet, dye will go to PA. Inlet dye will hit the opposite tricuspid valve, so the chamber, and if it is perimembranous, it will go to this. So based on this, you realize it is a proper VSD, which is of reasonable shine. I also want you all to see this structure, which is a tongue-shaped structure, which is continuation with aorta. This is the mitral valve, okay? So did everybody follow this? Please unmute and tell if you have followed.
Yes.
Yeah, so you understood, no? This is VSD, this is iliocranial, and this is a perimembranous VSD. You also see iotomitral continuity in this case. You also see right coronary artery. So this chamber is RV. See, in LAO view also, you know, you get an anterior-posterior relationship, no? So you have the sternum here. So anterior chamber is RV, posterior chamber is LV. And also see, how is it smooth? It is smoothly, you know, smooth, but smoothness predominantly is described on the septal side. Okay. Okay. Let's see this example of the this VSD. Now, can you all see what is on the right side? The one I'm showing now. I don't want you all to see this, but see this here. What do you see here? So you see a ventricular angio, again it is LAO, you see an injection, but you see some dye coming into the chamber, no? But you don't know exactly where is it coming from. So this is not ideally profiled. So what do you see here? I see a ventricular injection here. I see a dry coming into this chamber, but predominantly before it fills the chamber, it's actually filling pulmonary artery. Okay, so this is not a proper profile for this VSD, but we get some idea that VSD is present. But when the same view is done in a RAO30 view, you see that LV angio shows a proper projection and this VSD is actually an outlet VSD. Did you all follow this? Can somebody answer, Abhishek or whoever?
Yes, sir.
It's very clear, no? So any VSD, if you take angio, you will get some dye, but you have to profile it properly and identify the VSD. Like in this case, if you see, the RV is just hardly filling, but if you look at this point, the PA is filling well. So this is the outlet VSD, and if you want to take the angio, you have to make sure the angio is taken in the right view. Okay? Saurabh, did you follow?
Yes. Sir, explain again.
Okay, see, for example, let's see this example, first one. Okay, first angio only. Just look at this angio. What do you see? This is a LAO cranial view, no doubt about that. Catheter is pigtail, injection into LV. But along with LV, you see RV slightly filling and you see PA filling. So you have a clear doubt that there is VSD, but you are not able to profile the VSD well. Because what did we say? When you profile the VSD, you need to show a VSD, margins of VSD. Only if you are showing margins of VSD, you have profiled VSD well. Whereas now you see the same person's this angio. This is a RAO 30 degree view. And what do you see in this? You see LV angio. Okay, but you also see a connection. This is the VSD which has a proper margin. You see the jet going into RVOT and from RVOT directly entering PA. So this is a RV outflow VSD which is best profiled in RAO 30 view. Same VSD when it was taken in LAO cranial view, you get some suggestion, but you are not sure what kind of VSD is it. Okay, so in VSD, it's very important to profile it properly and take the right view. And in that right view, show that the margin of VSD are clearly seen. Also concentrate on the direction of the jet flow. Okay, is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so no need to explain, no? So understand different VSDs have different view, but it's also important for you to profile it properly in a particular angio. Concentrate on direction of jet. Inlet VSD, jet will hit opposite valve. Perimembranous VSD, I'm going to go back to perimembranous so that you understand it. Look at this. It's a beautiful angio of perimembranous. Look at the septum. Look at the profiling of VSD. You're able to see the margins of VSD very clearly. So that means here margins of, this is the septum, this is the aortic wall, but the margins of VSD, they are not blurred. I can even measure this VSD. That means this is the right view for this VSD. What is the view? LAO cranial. And look at the dye. Dye predominantly going into chamber and only after that going to pre-A. So this means this was a perimembranous VSD. Okay? Can I hear from somebody? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yeah, good. Yeah. So let's go to now One more angio. What do you see here? Can somebody describe this? Anybody? No problem. No wrong answer. I'm not your examiner.
Sir, this is a yellow cranial view, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Good.
Again, retrograde angiogram, sir. Use this one.
Pigtail catheter through aorta. You know, take your time, but go on answering.
Pigtail catheter through the descending aorta, arch ascending and into a chamber.
Yes.
Looks like ventricle, sir.
Yes.
There is simultaneously filling of the RV.
Yeah, looks but like you tell ventricle looks like LV, smoothly trabeculated. See, again, I want you all to concentrate. Sorry to interrupt you. Just for you to understand what does smooth mean. See, if I close this, this area is not smooth. Only the septal area is smooth. Okay? And look at the, you are seeing some structure here. Okay?
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Okay. Yeah, please go on.
And large muscular VSD, sir.
Very good. So now you know it is away from aorta. And it is a muscular VSD. Understood? And is this, who is the person who is answering?
Yes, sir. Pratik, sir.
Sorry, your name?
Sir, Pratik, sir. Pratik.
Pratik. Pratik, do you think this is the right view for this VSD or no? Is the view correct for this VSD or no?
Sir, we can see the margin, sir.
Very good. So, we can see the margin. So, this is the right view for this VSD. Okay? Perfect.
Yes.
Okay. Good, Pratik. So, let's see the next one. So, PDA angiogram. PDA, you know, what are the views for PDA? Lateral. Very important view. And the next view for PDA is actually RAO30. Always the opposite, you know, your opposite things look better. Okay. So, if you look at PDA is a left-sided structure. So, RAO30 is a better view. Okay, and lateral. This is how we measure PDA and upsize the device by 2 to 3 and divide it. So can you know you all can you know to describe this? No, can somebody describe this? What do you see? What view and what do you see? Yeah. Anybody, please.
So this is a pigtail catheter.
Yes.
This is lateral view.
Lateral. So how did you decide it is lateral and not a LAVO view?
So sternum we can
sternum.
See.
Very good. Very good. So extreme LAVO is lateral and you can see the sternum and you are able to see it. Yes. Good. So you know how to distinguish that. Yes. Then injection shows?
So injection shows in first angio there is a PDA.
Yes, there is a, you need to describe it, okay? You are right that it is PDA, but if it is wrong, you lose a lot of points. So, you better to tell injection into descending aorta showing a connection between
aorta and
descending aorta and PA. We don't know PA. Left PA, right PA, but we know it is PA. No? Suggest you have PDA. You also look at pulmonary valve. Sometimes you see a PR coming, you know, you are able to see pulmonary valve here, no? See here, this is pulmonary valve, the negative shadow.
Yes.
Sometimes you can even see PR there and it's connected to the anteromost chamber. Yes. So you see a PDA and the Leo phase showing LALV. Okay. You need to describe that. What do you see on the right image?
So device closure of PDA. We can see the device across the PDA.
Yeah.
Device
now whenever you all do PDA device closure, remember this trachea what you see is very important. Okay, so when you deliver your device, you need to deliver around trachea, this side and that side. This is a beautifully deployed device, and because there is ampulla, it is within the ampulla. You're seeing little flow, but the flow is through device. Peri-device flow, no issue, it's going to disappear. But all of you are able to see trachea, no? The trachea is an important landmark for PDA, okay? Okay, now discussing angio. Now, the theory is over. I hope you have no doubt in theory. I'm going to do some example, okay? So, first one, somebody, any one of you, keep alternating among each other. Describe the cath course. Who's going to do that? Cath course.
Sir, sir.
Yes, this is the IVC. Hello, yeah, please tell.
Yeah, this is through the IVC.
Yes, it's a venous. You think it is venous, so it's from IVC, RA, then?
It's not RA. Is it through the conduit, Fontan conduit and the gland?
No, typically, see, Fontan conduits don't go so high up, no? They don't go up. Fontan, you can go to PA, but you can't go up like this. The catheter is gone way up, no? See, the tracheal bifurcation is here. The PA will be around tracheal bifurcation. It's not this up. So something has gone way up, but then come down. Where do you think it is?
Right aortic valve.
Yes. What does it look like? If it was X-ray, what would you call it?
Figure of eight.
So where are you?
TAPVC.
Yes. So you're going to SVC, RA, IVC, RA, SVC, through the vertical vein, you're coming to the chamber and going to actually pulmonary vein, okay? This is pulmonary vein, it's not pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery is related to PA, no? Related to the bronchus and bronchus bifurcation, you need to go across the sternum. So this is pulmonary vein. So it's typical figure of eight and this is how it sees. Any doubts here? So in your exam, you could be asked about cath course. So is it clear? Lots of guesswork is needed in cath course. So you need to understand where did you start and where did you end. For example, here starting is venous side, so there is no doubt. Ending is pulmonary vein. Okay, it's not pulmonary artery, because pulmonary artery would have gone through the at the level of bronchus, no? This has no relation to bronchus at all. The ending is pulmonary vein. See, gland circuits are only on top. So the femoral vein won't go to gland circuit. And the Fontan goes, you know how it goes. So this is typical TAPVC. Okay? So ready for the next one?
Yes.
This one. Little more tougher one again. Who is going to answer this? Obviously, little tougher one for you to think. But just to say, otherwise, what is there in cath course? No, you know it is venous, you know it is artery. Can you guess where we are here in this case?
Sir, catheter from the femoral artery.
Correct.
To the aorta, arch.
Yes.
Ascending aorta, LV, from the VSD. Goes to the pulmonary artery, parked in the pulmonary artery.
Yes, pulmonary. This is the right answer. Why do we think it is aorta? Because it is coming here, turning. I discussed the other day. Venous catheter directly enter heart, artery turns. And see the pulsation. This is pulsating. The other one is also pulsating. And other one is related to the bronchus. So pulsating bronchus means that is PA, this is aorta, they are pulsating out of phase, and this is a chamber. Now this could be single ventricle, this could be DORV, this could be LV through VSD. So that part is not very clear. No, all three are possible. But what we know that it has ended in pulmonary artery to pulmonary capillary. Okay, pulmonary artery and end. Any doubts here? But see that it is not vein. Look at the pulsation of both these structures, indicating that both are in great artery. Okay? Any doubts? Any difference of opinion?
Sir, if any ajygous vein that is entering SVC and then to RA, RV and then PA, sir.
Okay. Ajygous continuation, it comes on the right side here. Ajygous continuation. But again, it doesn't pulsate the way this is pulsating. Okay. And that comes like, it's only on the same side of the sternum, the vertebra. It's not on the opposite side of the vertebra. We do have one example. I'll tell you how it looks when it comes. But it is on this side coming like this. And in ajygous is typically a right-sided structure. No? Yeah. This is a very easy one for whoever wants. Describe it. I just kept it because, the point has to be overemphasized. Yes, please go on.
Sir, the arterial, so the catheter is going from the femoral artery into the descending aorta, arch of aorta, then the ascending aorta and into a ventricular chamber. That ventricular chamber has the septum that is relatively smoother.
Just to stop you here, you are looking at septum, but you are going to tell people it's smoothly trabeculated chamber, okay? If they ask, oh, there is so much trabeculation here, then you say we look at septum, but you don't offer it. You say smoothly trabeculated chamber, okay?
Yes.
Okay, go on.
Plus, from this chamber, the outflow is seen into the aorta because the coronaries are also seen. And plus, just below the aorta, there is the contrast that is simultaneously filling the other chamber also. So, this is a VSD that is there.
Okay, good. What type of VSD is it?
Sir, it is perimembranous VSD because it is first filling into the opposite chamber and then it is going up.
Correct. And also it is profiled very well. No, you can see the profile. Sorry, I'm
okay. Yes,
it's profiled very well. So it's perimembranous. You see the chamber. So you all followed this. How many of you can see mitral valve in this case? RCA, I think everybody has seen mitral valve. Can you all see mitral valve? Here, see this negative shadow and there is iatomitral continuity, okay?
Yes,
this one, the white one, okay? That's the mitral valve and there is iatomitral continuity, okay? And RCA you can see. This is a LAO view, so you know the between, you can know. So can anybody tell me the relationship of aorta and PA? Not in this case, generally. Because this is one more question which people will ask. Relationship of aorta and PA.
Aorta is posterior and little bit on the right side as compared to the pulmonary
very
artery.
Good. So the mnemonic is RPI or RIP, you know, right, infero, posterior, no? So, when you say aorta, you're actually referring to aortic valve, okay? Relationship is between aortic wall or and pulmonary valve. You're not looking at the rest of the aorta. So, aorta is not left-sided. It's right infero-posterior, RIP. You remember that. Now, how which view will tell you whether it is right or left? Which will you tell it whether it is inferior, whether superior or inferior? How do you identify the relationship between aorta and PA? So in cases of DORV, cases of TGA, this is important. Can anybody tell which view will identify these things?
AP view, sir.
What does AP show among them? AP will tell you right or left, correct?
Or right.
Correct. AP will also tell superior or inferior, no? It's RIP, no? Right antero. But can AP say antero posterior?
No, sir.
The lateral view.
So which view do you need for antero posterior?
Lateral view, sir.
Yeah. Best is lateral, rarely LAO. Okay, because LAO and lateral are like cousins. So but it has to be lateral. But when you have doubt, even LAO can slightly help you. Okay. So remember this. I don't have a slide for that, but remember this. Okay. The fourth one, can anybody answer this? What do you see in this? Are you all bored? The class went on for more than 1 hour.
No, sir. No, sir.
Yeah. Describe this. No? Anybody, no problem. Start, describe.
Venogram view showing the filling of the IVC, sir, in the that of the RA, sir.
Correct. The IVC. Anything abnormal or it looks like normal?
Actually, it is coming from the ASIGS vein, sir. IVC is interrupted.
That part of information we don't know because see azygous does not, can azygous enter RA direct? No, azygous cannot enter RA, both the azygous cannot enter. Aesophagus will enter SVC, no?
Yes,
here
right.
You see an injection in abdomen, but you expect a venous injection to be on right side. Instead, you see the venous injection on left side. So it's likely to be situs inversus, no?
Right.
But look at the heart. Heart is still levocardia. It's not dextrocardia. Okay.
Isolated levocardia with the situs inversus.
Yes, situs inversus. Where do you think liver is?
Liver is on the
transport.
Left side only.
Yeah. Why is the right diaphragm high then? So right diaphragm is higher than left diaphragm, no?
Heart pushes the diaphragm down.
Very good. So good. I think if I was your examiner, I would have given you degree just for this. It's heart which pushes the diaphragm and not liver which pushes up the diaphragm. If it was liver, why? If it was liver is so important, then you know air under diaphragm should not push the liver down. So liver is positioned only because of negative abdominal pressure. It's heart which. So in this, you are not able to show the liver, although you are seeing hepatic veins on both the sides. No, you are seeing hepatic veins on this side and that side. So this is a case of situs inversus and levocardia. No, so whenever you have a situs and levocardia mismatch, what are the things which comes into your mind?
Complex congenital heart.
CCTGS. Yes, invariably complex. And also remember, it's invariably, if it is not too complex, they will have corrected TGA. Okay? Because atria will go with the situs, ventricle will go with the levocardia, dextrocardia. No? So that means in this case, you are already describing a right atria to the left side and left atria to the right side. And that means there is a ventricular inversion. No? So if it is not too complex, you're going to have a corrected TGA if you have mismatch between the situs and this. Okay. Now, who can describe this?
It is a venous catheter going on.
Yes.
From the IV.
Yeah, start with the view first.
It is AP view, sir.
AP view, yes. Then there is a venous balloon tip catheter. No, you are able to see the balloon?
Balloon tip catheter filling the ventricle, which is very trabeculated.
Yes.
And there is a regurgitation of the contrast into the RA. And
yes.
There is stenosis of the outlet.
Mm. What is the level of stenosis? Correct.
Subvalvular, sorry, infundibular level.
No, look at this. This is valve. See, there is subvalvular something. But look at the valve. Valve is thickened, no?
Thickened.
See, valve
okay.
is thickened. And also you see inkjet effect. See, from the valve, as if some ink is jetted, just concentrate on this area. From the valve, some inkjet effect. Can you see that? As if somebody is just like a piston, the dye going. This is very classical of a valvular stenosis. You see a thickened valve moving like a bird flapping, and you also see a MPA which is dilated, which is also valvular stenosis. So this is valvular stenosis with intact septum with some sort of RV dysfunction, lots of RV hypertrophy, lots of TR. No, that's what you see. All of you agree?
Yeah,
everybody
yeah.
follow?
Yeah.
Look at this flapping valve, okay? Thickened valve, normally pulmonary valve is not seen in the angio. If you see a valve like this, which is thickened, and concentrate on that inkjet part, you know, that's the sign of severe stenosis. Are you all able to guess? No, it's like a holy piston. If you have a piston, see there, inkjet, okay? And dilated PA. Yeah, what do you see here now? Can somebody describe this?
A thickened valve that is not moving, it is stiff, Noonan's.
This one? Yeah. But can we have a proper description? In exam, they are going to look for description. So please describe it properly, the view and everything.
Sorry, previous angio.
Sorry.
Sorry, yeah. Somebody asked something, sorry, I didn't get it. Did anybody ask anything? Can you describe this angio?
Sir, this is again the catheter is going through the IVC, RA, RV into the pulmonary artery.
Let's not make that mistake. View has to be first. It is?
AP view, sir.
AP may be slight cranial, but more or AP is fine. AP view, yes. A venous catheter, please use these words, okay?
So venous catheter
going into RA to RV a chamber.
Into the MPA, sir.
Yeah, more like outflow, not at in MPA. It has not crossed the valve, no? But it is in outflow of a chamber, no? It's not beyond the valve. You can see the valve. What do you see in this?
Both the great arteries are filling at same time, sir.
Very good. That indicates, what does that indicate? If there are both entering, there is VSD, no?
VSD.
Otherwise, why will so, both? Yes. What else do you see?
Right, what you call the... There is what you call valvular stenosis, supravalvular stenosis.
Yeah. No, this case, yeah, you describe what you see. That will help you. I'm going to stop here. So, if you see here, you see aorta, you see PA, no?
Yes,
PA, you see the valve which is narrowed and thickening. Look at this subvalve. Subvalve also is stenosis. Can you all see here? So, you see a subvalvular, you see a valvular, you see some narrowing in supravalve also. Okay, PA is much smaller than aorta, but it still seems adequately sized. So you described RVOTO, you have described VSD because aorta is filling, and now you describe the Leo phase. Leo phase indicates, see the blood coming now to LA, LV, again going into aorta, indicating this is a case of a TORF, not a DORV. Okay, TORF.
Yes,
because LALV blood is going to aorta again, so it's likely TORF and not a DORV. And somebody described it as simultaneous. No, if you see it carefully, PA is getting filled before aorta. Just see this now. See, first PA, yes, then aorta. So it's very likely of a classical TORF. Okay? All of you followed? Yeah, this is very important. Yeah, at this point, they're going to ask you for, to see the exact level of obstruction. Lateral view is better, okay? Rather than AP view, lateral view is better. But even in this view, if I stop in the right frame, see, you realize there is stenosis here, there's stenosis in the valve, there is stenosis in supravalve, RV is hypertrophied, no? And lateral will be better. Aorta seems to be inferior, and aorta seems to be lateral. Aorta seems to be on right side, even in this view, indicating that relationship of aorta and PA are normal. But a lateral view would have told you better about RVOTO, would have told better about the position, and also would have told which of them is anterior or posterior. Okay? Followed?
But remember, you have to learn
the indices here.
Hello?
Yeah?
Sir, how can we see aortomitral continuity in this?
So, aortomitral
continuity. How will we differentiate it from DORV?
Yeah, see, we can't distinguish based on aortomitral continuity. That part is not seen. But what are the suggestions you have? You have an injection in RV, filling PA first and then aorta. The Leo phase blood, which is coming back, is going to aorta and not to PA, indicating that LV is connected to aorta and RV is predominantly connected to PA. So you can't be 100% sure this is not DORV, but there is a lot of suggestion that this could be classical TORF. Okay. What else is important? The relationship between aorta and PA. Most of the time, DORV, two-thirds of the time, the relationship between aorta and PA are altered. Side by side is much more commoner in DORV. Whereas here, the relationship appears normal. Aorta appears to be on right. Aorta appears to be inferior to PA. Okay. So, their only suggestion to be more sure, you need a LV angio to look at aortomitral continuity, and you should need a lateral angio to look at this. Okay. So can I'm going to put the next one. Can anybody answer?
Sir, I have a doubt before this, sir. Hello, sir.
Hello.
what was the doubt? Yeah.
Sir, if better we have to decide arch-sidedness, which view would be better, sir, to say it's a right-sided arch or a left-sided arch?
Yeah, yeah. Very, very important question. I have a slide on that later. Arch-sidedness should be AP only. You can't do it with RAO or LAO, you know, because they will alter. Right-left is best picked up in an AP view. Right-left, okay? LAO, RAO doesn't give right-left, but right-left is best in AP view. I have a slide I'll show you. Yes. What do you see in this case?
Again, the Venus.
Yeah, not everything is complex, so you can go on and answer. Yeah. What do you see?
The catheter is going again from the
Venous side, yes.
Venous side, sir. Venous catheter filling the pulmonary confluent pulmonary arteries.
Yes.
And
good
then,
size. Good size pulmonary arteries. Yes.
Pulmonary arteries. Then the pulmonary veins are filling.
Mm-hmm.
Anomalous venal connection to the left lower lobe. Right lower.
Okay, good. Yes. So what's happening? Yes. You can see the anomalous syndrome joining the hepatic vein. So it's a Shimitar syndrome. No. Good. You can see the proper Shimitar. So there is PAPVC. There could be hypoplasia. There is PAPVC. Okay. So can somebody describe? I think muting audio will be needed by one of the person. Who can describe this view and everything?
Simultaneous as venous and arterial catheters are seen. Yeah.
Catheters are there both the places, correct?
The arterial catheter is filling the chambers and then the aorta. The arterial catheter in the chamber is in the anterior chamber, sir.
Okay, arterial is in the. How do you know it is anterior? What view is this?
Lateral view, sir.
Are you sure it is lateral? Look at the way diaphragm is moving up and down.
LAO, sir.
No, LAO cranes. Not even LAO. That's the strange part. Look at the spine.
AP.
Yeah, it's an AP view, no? So in an AP view, what are all the abnormality you see? You have a venous catheter. Where is the venous catheter?
So venous catheter, if we compare with the venous catheter, then it will be anterior, sir.
Anterior posterior in an AP view is not possible, no?
Venous on left side and
yeah,
arterial.
Venous is on left side and arterial is on the right side. Indicating?
Yes, sir.
Indicating? Situs inversus, no?
Okay.
And what you see, the heart is actually on the left, right side, no? So you have situs inversus and you have dextrocardia. No, situs inversus, dextrocardia. That much is clear? Okay. Now the arterial catheter is coming from the aorta. You can see the aorta and entering a chamber. Chamber is it coarsely trabeculated or firmly trabeculated? Is it smooth or coarse?
Looking like coarse, RV.
Yeah, looking like coarse, RV. And if you have doubt, look at the, you know that it's filling aorta. And if you have doubt, just look at the coronaries if possible. See? Sorry. Look at the coronaries, if possible. We discussed this, no? Yeah, I'm going to stop. Sorry, it's not stopping. Yeah. See here, this is the left coronary. If you see carefully, you'll see the left coronary coming here, supplying this. So this is likely, coronaries follow the ventricle. This is likely LV. So this is a case of situs inversus dextrocardia with CCTGA, no? Corrected TGA. All of you agree? ventricular inversion and great artery inversion, because the aortic catheter is actually in RV and the venous catheter is likely to be in LV. We are not able to see. Look at the coronary, you see the left main dividing into LAD and RCA. And also, this is what we discussed in the beginning, septum in a CCTGA is best profiled in an AP view. No? Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so this is a case of CCTGA.
Sir, if the situs is inverted, atria also should be inverted, no sir?
Correct. Atria, situs is inverted, that means atria is also inverted. But yeah, dextrocardia right means ventricle is also inverted, no?
So then it will become right atrium entering into the right ventricle and to the aorta, no sir?
No, right atrium is entering, right, see there is a venous catheter, no? Venous catheter is in right atria. Where is it entering? It's entering into a ventricle which is likely left ventricle, no? Okay. The pigtail, the balloon tip should be in LV because it's not RV. This is not the sub-aortic chamber, no? So this is LV. Agreed?
Yes.
Okay,
sir. Right atrium, but it's not in LV because the pigtail is in RV, no?
Okay,
so this is, it's almost goes hand in hand. Very rarely you'll have, you know, like a TGA kind of picture. If atria is inverted, invariably they autocorrect themselves. There are exceptions to this rule. Most of the time they autocorrect. This is very easy. Can somebody tell this case?
Balloon atrial septostomy.
Yeah, again, the balloon atrial septostomy. What is the basic condition you are dealing with?
TGA with intact septum.
Yeah, very clear. But not. What are the other condition where would you, where you would do this same procedure?
Pulmonary atresia with intact IVS.
Intact IVS. Yeah, you could do that. Yes. Then.
Even so, pulmonary
atresia. You could do it in tricuspid atresia if the connection is not great. No. You could also do it in TAPVC because one of the site of TAPVC producing problem is interatrial septum. No? One of the site of obstruction, if interatrial septum is, you know, the communication is bad, systemic flow in TAPVC will be bad. So even in them, you could do this. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So this, who is going to answer this? The easy one. Easy one. Quickly, I think it's 8:43. We'll finish by 9. More, quicker you answer, more I can show you. We need to talk, thank Rocky because he's made a lot of slides. He's made 22 of these. We are only at 10. Any takers?
Sir, again the venous catheter.
Yes, venous catheter going into RA, SVC. Yeah, and to the vertical vein, no?
Vertical vein, sir. So
yes, figure of vein. But you look at SVC here, it's an adult patient. SVC is aneurysmal. Can you see that aneurysmal SVC? The big, huge SVC, okay? Okay, next one. Somebody asked this, so answer this quickly now.
Right aortic arch.
Right aortic arch.
Okay, so it's a, again. Yeah. So whoever asked, I hope the answer is clear. It's a AP view, okay? Aorta is on the right side here. It's mirror image, you see? The brachiocephalic can be seen well. Is it mirror image or either way? No, so it's a right aortic arch. What are the associations of right aortic arch? If you have right aortic arch, what is the first thing which comes to your mind?
Truncus arteriosus.
Yeah, the first thing that should come to your mind is most common association and most common condition. These two questions are asked to you. What is the most common association?
VSD pulmonary atresia with pulmonary atresia.
Yeah, most common association is VSD because all the condition you tell will have a VSD. Okay, like you talk about the most common condition is TOF with pulmonary atresia because 50% of them will have right arch. Sicker the TOF, righter the arch. Okay, that's the rule. So sickest of the TOF will have right arch. So most common, 50% of TOF with pulmonary atresia will have right arch, 40% of truncus will have right arch, and 25-30% of classical TOF will have right arch. But the point is almost all of them do have VSD, no?
Yes, sir.
All three of them are VSD. So if somebody asks, most common association of right arch is actually VSD. Most common condition, again, little controversy. It could be truncus. It could be top with pulmonary atresia. The actual number of patients with top with pulmonary atresia is smaller, but this is how you get right arch. Only way to pick it up is AP view and not RAO or LAO view. Okay. Yes. Who's going to answer this? Question number 12. It's 8:46. 14 more minutes to finish. How much ever you want.
Sir, again, the arterial catheter pigtail is placed in the descending aorta and the angiogram is taken. The descending aorta is being filled and there are MAPKAs filling the pulmonary arteries.
Very good. There is a huge
MAPKA.
Huge MAPKA which is on the which can be seen on right side or left side. If I call it truncus, is it right or wrong? It almost looks like PA to me, you know. So I can argue this is truncus. What's your answer?
Truncus.
You understood the question, no? The yes. Both arteries to me looks like PA, so I'm going to call it truncus. Is it right or wrong?
Truncus, it will arise from ascending aorta.
Very good. Truncus, hemitruncus, all have to be ascending. So this at one point was called pseudo-truncus, but it can never be truncus, okay? So anything arising from descending aorta is not truncus, and it is typically, what is this? This is likely in top with pulmonary atresia, no?
Of where there you see
direct collateral. So just a lesson for you, please read about aortopulmonary collateral, direct, indirect, bronchial, what embryological aid they develop and what are the problem they create. Okay. Next one. What do you see here? Cath course, position and answer. 8:48. So quick.
Again, the venous catheter, sir.
Yes.
Venous catheter,
yes.
Going into the ezygous vein, vertical vein, horizontal vein, and into the SVC RA filling, sir.
No. The catheter. I mean, what's happening actually is, please see the last frame of the film. See the catheter. Sorry, the catheter has actually gone to coronary sinus. LSVC. So this patient has bilateral
SVC. Left arm.
Yeah. Okay. It's gone through the L. I'm not able to stop it. But all of you followed, no? It's gone through
the pulmonary sinus
to the LSVC, and there is a communication between both the SVCs. Okay. That bridging vein is patent. There is communication between both SVC. How? What is the difference between this? Is I'm not going to answer this. This is for you to think. LSVC and vertical vein looks almost the same. Okay, what is the difference between them anatomically? Please read this. Okay, LSVC, vertical vein. Apart, I'm not talking about the direction of flow in echo. I'm talking about embryology. Okay, please read that. Next question, 14th question. This is a spotter.
This is the arterial catheter filling the multipurpose catheter filling the coronary, sir. Right coronary is aneurysmally dilated and there is retrograde filling of the left coronary system into the pulmonary artery.
Suggestive of alkaposar. Yes. So all of you followed this? So you can see a PA,
yes,
you can see the PA entering. Anybody has doubt with alkapa?
No,
somebody else also tell yes or no? All of you are following this, no?
It's alkapa,
yes.
Sorry.
Yes, sir.
It's alkapa, very clear. You can also see PA. So that's why the continuous murmur comes from that side. It's aneurysmal, okay? Okay, next one. Again a spotter, 8:50. We'll try to finish as many. Start. I mean, see, if you don't, even if you in exam, I mean, here there are obviously many of you, at least the view and catheter, just start and keep thinking as you're doing it. Okay. Very good. Whoever answered is perfectly right. So this is the RAO view, not cranial. Arterial catheter in LV, injection shows basal hypercontractility, apical ballooning. So this is Takotsubo. Excellent. Next one, yes.
The angled pigtail catheter angiogram into the chamber.
Yes.
Showing obliteration of the apex, sir. Spread of appearance, apical hypercarteritis.
EMF.
Yes. Yeah. No, it's likely HCM, okay? Hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. EMF also has apical this one. You're also supposed to measure the thickness from the coronary. If you can see coronary will mark the epicardium. This is classical of apical HCM, but proper, just the apical obliteration, that's more common in EMF. Patient also has a pacemaker which helps these patients, no? So, next one. Question number 17.
LV non-compact.
Very good, very good. So it's the RFO view above LV angio indicating lots of non-compaction. So these are the cases where it becomes so difficult to distinguish this from RV, but it is non-compaction. One more spotter.
Pulmonary AV malformations.
Are you seeing the venous phase very fast? AV malformation pulmonary is when you see the vein fast.
Pulmonary thromboembolism, sir.
Yes, multiple thrombus, chronic apparently, no? PAs appeared dilated, and no, I think it's acute. They have done some thrombosuction, okay? So, but you see the thrombus. Okay, next one. We have seen it once before, no?
Classical.
Yeah, but more than that, try to describe AP, stenosis and all that, okay? Okay, this one. Again, you have seen it, I think. No, no, you're not seen. Yes. This is important. Yeah. Go on. 8:52. Everybody is very fast. We are going to finish all the slides. Yes.
Again, pigtail catheter into the from the IVC, RA, RV into the MPA, sir, pulmonary artery. Filling the pulmonary arteries. Then in the lever phase, the pulmonary veins are filling. There is a vertical horizontal vein, and then the atria are filling. Suggestive of TAPVC, sir.
Supracardiac, no? Supracardiac, TAPVC. Very good. Always, whenever, see, this is what they're going to start with. They're going to ask some questions. Be ready for those questions in exam. They're not going to stop at this, okay? They're going to ask the physiology. They might ask why infracardiac is always obstructive, or which is more common, which has better mixing, things like that. Be ready for 2-3 other questions. So when you discuss with your friends, make sure you know the theory also well, okay? Next one.
Before angio.
Sorry, you want the previous angio?
In previous angio, in lever phase, what is filling? So that is aneurysm.
Yeah, lever phase, it is a vertical vein. This is the right and left together, they form a chamber. Vertical vein is going up, joining the brachiocephalic here. Aneurysmal SVC, the same case which you saw last time, coming to RA. Veins form a chain, they don't go to LA. They form a chain, go up, forming the vertical vein, brachiocephalic, SVC, and down. Okay?
So now, sorry.
Yeah, TAPVC is a favorite. Okay, in cath, TAPVC is a favorite. Somebody is going to show you TAPVC. What do you see here?
Sir, venous angiogram from this bilateral SVC and draining into the coronary sinus.
LSVC. Very good. So it's a bilateral SVC. Both are communicating. Draining into coronary sinus. You are able to see coronary sinus and you are able to see the veins. Okay? Very good. Next one.
Right one is the pigtail catheter going from the descending aorta arch into ascending aorta and into the chamber, sir. It is a normal.
Okay.
The septum appears to be intact only, sir.
Okay. Anything else? Do you find anything funny?
The coronaries are not filling, sir.
Yeah, they're not at filling. But do you see something here? The funny thing here? See, there's nothing in LA.
Outlet.
No, not a VSD. RV is not filling at all, but there's something filling in this chamber. So this could be a submitral aneurysm, you know, if you have something
okay,
like mitral aneurysm, something in the LV going up and down, but not really going into LA. Okay. What is this? I'm sure you have seen enough of this.
Left SVC.
Yeah. Through the coronary sinus, less SVC. Unroofing of this will produce sinusitis. Otherwise, it doesn't matter. This could be the last. And, oh, we still have 4 minutes. Yes. What is this?
Pulmonary AV fistula, sir.
Yes. So, injection AV.
Pulmonary AV fistula.
Injection showing a rapid venous phase, no? So this is pulmonary. How do they present?
Sinusitis.
Yes. Predominantly sinusitis with structurally normal heart. And if you do a bubble contrast, you realize. So with that, we come to an end. So anybody has any doubts?
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Any doubts, please ask. Most of your exam going this time, is it?
Yes,
yes
sir.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Most of you are, no? Yeah, yeah. So, yes, any sir. Doubts you have, you please feel free to ask. So, this was, I think, the last of our class for this batch. So, anything in the first three things, you have 1 or 2 minutes where before we can close. If you have any doubts, you can ask. No doubts? First class, second class, third class. We actually tried to change the system. In the first two, the interaction was not possible. So we requested Rohit to change it. This is better. This is interactive. At least we know we are all in the same page. So in CAT, don't worry too much. Just follow the things. Don't think about, you know, very complex things you don't have to know. But theory you need to know. There is always a theory. Like TOF, they're going to ask you about indexes. And single ventricle, they're asking you to something. So you need to know about VD shunt. You need to know about criteria, you know, those kind of things. Okay. So
yes,
are we done? Rohit, if there's no other, so nobody has any question in any of the classes before? All those tracings, I'm sure you all followed and we did do some example.
Thank you, sir, for such a wonderful class, sir.
Yeah,
thanks
yeah.
a lot, sir.
Thank you, thank you.
Okay. It was
all the best for your exams. Feel free to
thank
contact
you so much.
If you have any doubts.
Thank okay? you so much,
thank
sir.
You. Yeah. Thanks.
Thank you, sir. It was great learning.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bye, bye. Good luck, good luck.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yes, sir. It's all done. People have started leaving now. So
yes.
I could see that because it's already 2 hours.
Yes.
So, yeah. So thank you so much for joining in, and thanks Dr. Ranjan for taking this up. I think this is really helpful, and all the participants are going to take the advantage of whatever the learning they have, these three, all the episodes of your courses. So thank you so much, and I hope this platform must be useful and you might have find it better than the other ones. The previous ones.
Yeah, this is better. Thank you, Rohit. Huh? Take care.
Can you give the recording of all the four classes, sir?
Yeah, sir? Yeah. I think Rohit will put it. Yeah. Dr. Sudhakar has already put it in the KMC group. Okay, some of them are already available in YouTube. Rohit is going to put all these three. Okay.
Sir, can
we will send the information once it is uploaded on the website. You can see that.
Sir, PPT can be shared, sir.
I'll send it to Rohit. We can share the PPT. No issues at all. We can share the PPT.
Previous also, sir, we would like to receive.
Sure. You be in touch with either Rohit or if you have my number, write to me directly. I will send it to you. Okay?
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.